Hi, welcome back to Educate WordPress, where we talk everything and all about WordPress. I'm Aisha, and in this video, we're going to see how you can create a backup or migrate your data into another website in just few simple steps. So this is basically an import-export procedure that happens like very often when you are having a website or when you even develop a website locally or anything of those things. This you can just create a backup and export into or import into your website. So let's see how this is done. And before we get into the video, don't forget to subscribe as we come up with videos every week on WordPress and WooCommerce to help you get your website performance and experience on top. So let's get right into the video. So we are going to do this in two methods, one without the plugin and one with the plugin. So without the plugin, if you are someone who don't trust in too much of plugins or confused which plugin to choose and all those things, you can just use this manual method, which is very useful and very easy. So let's see. You just have to go to the tools and you will be able to see import, export and data. And also there is another option which is export personal data or erase personal data that is related to your author or user or all those data. Those are the personal data. Those are considered as the personal data. Then you have the import, export option. So you want to export it first. So click on to the export and choose with what all content you want to do. Which is posts, pages, products, variation, orders, refunds, coupons. All these are basically WooCommerce website procedures. And if you have another website, you have little options over here. So I'm just going to do with the alt content. You just have to download the export file. Click onto the download and you will be able to see that. So that backup is done and it's in the XML format. As you can see, this will be in extended format. So if you want to import it, I'll show you that also. You have to click onto the import. So here what you have to do is there are few import options over here. Since we downloaded the WordPress part, you have to install the WordPress. There's another plugin for this for this import purpose. So you have to just click on to the install now and run importer. So here what happens is there's a plugin, basically WordPress extender RS. This uploaded file you have to import it over here. So you want to click choose the file and click on to this and just upload the file and import it, and that's it. That's how you can create an import. And also you can there's another other, like, since you have imported those data, you can just click on to the users and other things. So you just have to submit and the import will be done on the spot. Then with the plugin, if you are someone, you don't want to do this, you want some really good measures to be taken, you can just install a plugin. So I'm going to the method 2, where you can add a new plugin which is called all-in-one WordPress migration. So I'm just going to type the migration word over here. All right, so you will be able to see all-in-one WP migration. Obviously, WP is WordPress. So I'm just going to install it. And after installing it, you will be able to see in the dashboard. So if you are someone who is not into that host thing, you don't know, you don't have an idea about the databases, all those things, you can choose this method very easily. Otherwise, you'll have to depend on this PHP, SQL, MyPHP admin, all those things. So you don't have to go into that hassle when you are having this. All right. So we have just installed the plugin and I'm just going to activate this plugin right now. So once you have activated this, we have it on the dashboard and you will be able to see two options, which is import, export and backup. So if you want to create just a backup, you can click on to this and you can just create a backup from here, and it will take some time and just retrieve the files. Okay, this is being done. The time depends upon the variations in the hosting website, like which is a hosting provider you have chosen. You'll be able to the faster it will be. So you can just download this data from here. All right, so we have just created the backup. So in case you want to let's say you have made some changes or just gone wrong, or you just want to retrieve an old version of your website, you can just click on to go on to over here. You can download this create backup, or you can just restore it and download it and reinstall, or you just have to click on to the restore button, and your old version, this the restored version will be restored in your website. So otherwise, what you have to do is you can just click on to this download the whatever backup you have created, or just go to export and do the same procedure. You have to export, and you have to export it over to a file. You can just click on to the file, and this thing will be downloaded. The file will be downloaded, which is basically whatever in your website, like whatever data you have in your website will be downloaded into your computer. You just have to click the download. We're just not going to do that right now. It'll take some time, obviously. So, and you have to go to import it in the another website, or whichever website you have to you need to import it. You just have to install the same plugin and click on to the import section over here, and just click on to the import, and click on to the file and upload the file whichever we have already downloaded. You just have to upload it over here. So you'll have a dialog box opening over here in between. You just have to click on to the proceed. That might come scary, but don't worry, you just have to click on to the proceed button, and that's how you can just import the site data into your website. And these are simple, two easy steps for you. One is manual by creating exporting your data, and exporting it basically means creating a backup. That's it. So what all-in-one WP does is you can in the backup session, you can restore it whenever you want, right? So whichever version you wanted, just click on to the restore. So that's it. That's all about today's video. We have just learned how you can import, export, and create backup, and also migration of your website. So if you have any queries or questions related to WordPress or WooCommerce on HKWP, we are very much happy to bring contents on to you. Please comment down what all you need help with, or whichever video you want to make us do, and we'll be right up with the content. So we'll see you in another video. Bye.